Hello, everybody. I'm Sirkin. It's Monday. We're a little bit like 35 minutes late, but that's okay. Sometimes some things are worth waiting for. Thank you guys for being here. I have guests. They're on hold. They'll be off hold in a second. I'm just gonna say right out the gate, though, that I've decided my intro video. Before it was the outro video, but now the intro video is the absolute best part of this entire stream. I get excited when I hear it. There's a train going by. Hold on, I'm gonna close my window so that doesn't happen. All right. And yeah, I almost replaced it. And then I showed it to some people who I stream with and was like, "What do you think?" And they essentially said that they liked the older one better. And so that was a thing. So if you guys hate the current one, you can blame people. You can send me messages after the stream and I'll let you know where to send your angry letters. But yeah, that's my story. I have guests. I hear them clicking. Skylius.
Me.
That's you. Oh, that was you
Sorry.
clicking too?
Yeah.
Oh, you are just the worst. Say hi and tell these people a little bit about who you are in case they've never been here or just don't know who you are.
Everybody probably knows who I am, sort of, but I'm a streamer. And I play P99 occasionally.
Well, I'm gonna throw your link in chat so that you don't have to.
Thank you.
Oh, you're very welcome. You stream lots of games. I know you're not just an EverQuest streamer, but you do have a good stream. And thanks for joining us this fine evening. I know you do druid things on P99.
Yeah, no, I'm doing it off stream mostly right now, but I like saying that I'm a supporter of P99 streamers because you can usually find me in other people's streams, so.
Yeah, and I know that you have definitely put in some time streaming P99 yourself, even if you're not doing it right now.
A bit.
So, well, it's appreciated because there's people who search for EverQuest and then they see this classic EverQuest and they're like, "Well, what is this? That looks like actual Freeport that I remember." And then they check it out and then you answer their questions and send them to P99 and we appreciate the shit out of that.
Yeah.
Yeah, so thanks.
You're welcome.
And then we have the very best, my legal counsel and representation, and someone who will pay more attention to chat tonight than I've paid to chat in the last 2 years. Uber Bandit.
Yeah.
Hi, buddy.
Hello.
I missed you.
I
I
missed you
missed
too.
you too. I missed you too. Okay, sorry. Sorry.
Look, Skyly has missed you too.
I heard.
I'm
Okay.
throwing your link in chat too. Uber Bandit probably has the
Seriously,
most complicated stream, or not complicated, but complex setup stream I've ever seen. He's got soundboards and different microphones to catch different sounds. Sometimes they're computer sounds, sometimes they're made up by him sounds. He has supermodels dancing in the background. They're usually Asians. There's lava lamps that will tell your fortune. It's definitely worth checking out. Right? That's pretty accurate, wouldn't you say?
yeah, all 3 times I've done it.
I mean, you don't have to tell him that. I wouldn't have told him that.
I mean,
All 3 times
I
today is
still
what he
have
meant.
like 101 followers, so you know.
I feel like that's just 101 people that stopped using Twitch and me.
No, I still. What's fucked up is I still occasionally get followers, and it confuses the crap out of me.
When's the last time you logged into P99?
Actually, maybe a month ago. I went in and ran around for like 15 minutes and went, nah.
Wait, hold on. You got an important message, Sirkin. Can I read it to you real
Yo,
quick? If you
yeah,
don't read
feel
it, I'll read
free.
it to you.
Yeah, feel free.
It's from a guy named Fingers.
Hi, Fingers.
Hi, Fingers.
Oh, Fingers, you're super
Yeah.
popular
Wait,
right
no, wait,
now.
wait, wait. It
All
says,
right.
hey, just want to let you know that you and every single person on staff are wonderful people. Rogan can paint my nails. 15-day ban is nothing. After all, wait, sorry, can't read. After it is over, we will go back to dominating the server like nothing happened. Lols. You can't stop us, you fucking asterisk, asterisk, asterisk.
Why did it block the second word but not fucking?
Because I think you... I found out that, okay, actually, you can say the word dick, but you can't say... Oh, no, you can't say dick. You can say dicks, plural.
You can also say dick, as we learned Saturday.
Yes.
Yes.
So I'll make sure... Can you let Rogan know he needs a manicure?
Fingers? Yeah, no, I'll definitely...
Manicure. Yeah.
I mean, so. I don't think that was fingers, to be perfectly honest, because I don't think fingers would be that stupid. It's not because of, like, something we would do, but just because his own guild would pretty much crush his face right off his head if he legit just did that.
See? Oh, wait, Tupac got it. What? Never mind.
I don't know how I'm seeing this. I have a bad word filter turned on to protect my innocent eyes from this vulgar language.
Yeah, he just said fingers, just said Rogan is great at painting nails. I want him to paint your nails. No, I'm seriously reading this. But it makes
I'm
sense.
Reading what you're reading.
Okay, maybe I just have some really weird IRC stuff going on right now. I don't even know. Okay, so we'll go on. Sorry.
No, you're good. You're good. Well, that person is either super upset because his guild got suspended, or he's trying to make things worse for a guild that just got suspended, because a guild got suspended, and it's not really a secret, because there's at least 3 threads about it on the P99 forums, and basically, there's rules, and... Some of the rules you might agree with, some of the rules you might think are stupid as hell. I know I've heard Famas's opinion on the line. But like them or dislike them, they're there. And one of the rules say you cannot have a tracker get FTE. And one of the rules say you cannot camp out in the vicinity of raid mobs. When those things happen, you're DQ'd essentially. And if you're DQ'd, it doesn't mean you kill the mob anyway. And if you kill the mob anyway, you get killed. And that's it. And so that happened, and then they felt that was unfair, so they thought it would be fun to talk shit to the head of the server. And that didn't work out super well for them at all. And so then it got worse. And that's it.
Wait.
Yes?
They can't kill dragons because they FTE'd with a tracker?
They can't kill dragons because they had somebody camped out in the vicinity of Naggafin, I believe for... You know, I don't even know why. I don't know if it was for tracking. I don't know if it was to turn in something to Ragefire. I have no idea why. But for whatever reason, they were camped in too close to Naggafin. And then that nerd got FTE on Naggafin. And then that nerd's guild killed the dragon.
Oh, that's not good.
That's not good. You don't even know what level 35 looks like, and you know that's not good.
Yeah.
Yeah.
First I was going to be like, how does someone mess up the don't pull with a tracker thing?
Yeah.
That's impossible.
I know, but it's actually... You say that, but it's happened. Trackers have absolutely gotten FTE because they try to get... They inch closer and closer and closer to try and get an advantage, and then they inch too close and an AE goes off. And then that's it. And then they get mad. They get so mad. People are so mad. I was like bottom of the list on everybody's favorite person list last night, and then Rogan made a post, and all of a sudden I wasn't. So that was good. Oh. Again, like, I don't know.
Like, 3 years ago, I understood, like, that people were this intense about a video game, or even this pretend intense about a video game.
Sure.
3 years later, I can't believe it anymore.
They're not pretending, just so you know. They're not pretending. At all.
Like, are you certain?
Mm-hmm.
They're super serious. They are super mad. You should hear some of the things that I have heard.
There's so many things to do, though. They aren't EverQuest.
Mm-hmm. I have officers of this guild that have come to me apologizing for some of the shit that they've seen because they're so displeased with it. Like, yeah. When the guild, when some of, I won't say all of them, but when at least some of the officers in your guild are like, wow, that's fucked up. Like, you know it's bad. Because usually all the players can get together and bashing the staff. They get in guild chat or they get in team speak, and it's their safe little area, and everyone's on the same page, and me and Rogan and Bracknar and Landris or Swish, we're all the worst fucking people in the world. Never Nilbog. Nobody ever says bad about Nilbog because he's a saint. But the rest of us are scumbags. But don't send Rogan messages telling him that. Like, why would you do that? Why on earth would you do that? Like, oh, I'm so mad. You know what's going to make it better? Sending the project manager fucking hate tells.
Yeah,
I don't know. Right. Maybe just because I've like been a part of a couple like smaller project things, and it's like, you understand that without the person in charge, like, none of this exists. You owe everything to them.
People are retarded. People think that you can just like replace Rogan and plug and play some kind of different thing, and you can't. Like, a lot of people should know. I know people who listen here often know this because I rant about the same shit all the time. Swish, why don't you log in and handle some in-game petitions, pal?
Yes. I'm sorry, Swish.
Yeah.
Get on that. Those petitions aren't going to answer themselves.
Mm-hmm.
What are you doing in a stream of all things? You're a staff member.
Yeah, for real. You're not supposed to have free time to enjoy to yourself. And you better not be playing any other games either, especially Rust. Because let me tell you, if I find out you're playing that game, we're going to have fucking problems, pal. Big, big problems. And you don't want that to be a thing.
Oh, Snorlaxel wants to know if this is a weekly dev blog. He's never seen one of these before.
It's funny you mention that. I feel like, being that Uber Bandit has been on roughly 70 of these.
Mm-hmm. That's oddly appropriate.
That he would know?
Yeah.
I don't know anymore. It's definitely not a dev blog. I can say that because I'm not a dev. And Skylius, are you a dev?
No, I just told you AFK for a second. You disobeyed the rule.
I was trying to interject. I was going to save this guy. I was going to save him.
Oh,
I was ready
shit.
For it.
Hold on. Let's try it again.
Yeah.
So can ask me a question.
Words.
No. She's not. You know what?
What?
You know what?
What?
What? In fact, like, I remembered that I don't actually have to, like, read out every question anymore, because when you watch Twitch VODs, like, it shows a scroll of the chat.
Not anymore.
Yeah.
I took the chat out of my VODs.
What? Ah, okay, so I have to do it still.
Yeah.
Alright, I still have a job.
Yeah. Welcome back, you're hired.
Alright, I'm in. No, this isn't a dev blog. Well, this started...
Wait, I didn't even get... Time out. Uberan, I didn't even get to ask you, are you a dev? All right, continue.
Okay.
There's no devs here. That's my point.
Oh, yeah, no. There's no devs anywhere.
Well, there are devs somewhere. We keep them locked in the basement of our Discord channel.
Keep them locked in, crap. I had a thought, and the thought involved that one zone off of, the erudite place. That, like...
Kira Island.
No. The one that came out with Velius. That makes their faction not suck because the evil dudes can go in there.
Wait, Iridin place in Velius? Peniel! No.
What?
Peniel?
No.
God.
I mean, Peniel's the city, but there's a sub area in there that.
The hole?
Until Velius.
The hole?
Warrens.
The Warrens? Stonebrunt Mountains? Something?
Okay. Yes. I was gonna make a real. Okay, we're really long balling the joke now, but here we go.
Oh, we're telling a joke?
Warrens because of how. Many people were like, why aren't the warrants open yet? And, like, dev things.
Can I... No. Look. Mm-hmm. I'm gonna do some science real quick.
Yeah. Crash going into the warrants again? Because, you know, 3 months ago or whatever it was.
No, I'm never going to the warrants again.
Uh...
I don't even know how people zone into that. I saw Kalau P99. He's another EverQuest streamer you guys should check out. It's I don't have fancy Nightbot things, so you nerds are just gonna have to trust me. But it's Kalau P99. Go there on Twitch. Follow him. He's good people.
Wanna say that again but slower?
Kalau P99.
Yeah, better? Because you kind of just went Kalau.
Whatever. People, that's what you said. They can just play it back in slow motion.
Yeah.
So here's the thing. Being that I'm a GM, I can open the door to the back of the North Freeport Bank.
That sounds like a dangerous power.
And I feel like I should be able to just lock people in here. Because how are they going to get out?
I feel like someone might follow you in and actually.
I feel like someone just tried to follow me in, to be perfectly honest.
Wait. Can we see... I've never seen your gear.
Are you talking me?
Yeah, you.
What do you... Alright. Here's my gear. You are inspecting Sirkin. I can't right-click these things, though, can I? No. We'll just do it this way.
We also have to wait, like...
I know.
Oh, trust me. I learned this when three of us were in Crystal Caverns, and you guys had probably the best 30 minutes of your life laughing at my goddamn misfortune.
Guard Kevin, you will be missed.
Yes.
Guard Kevin's an asshole.
Guard Kevin was your best. He helped you out so much in there.
He didn't help me at all. He just stood there laughing. Like, was that a... That Dark Elf was, like, the least helpful person ever. Ever. He's like, hey, no, follow me. I totally know where to go. And I was like, okay, I'll trust you, fellow Dark Elf. No, yeah, he didn't know shit. Someone just tried to walk through my door. People know I'm in here. Oh. So.
No. Nobody knows.
I'm being sneaky. My gear is going to show up on screen and like...
No, we've seen it for a while now.
Earring is a...
But I'm linking. I'm making it fucking big and sexy.
Earring is a guide health, some strength, some saves. The eye patch of
open.
Low? Leo?
Look, it doesn't even matter. It's an eye patch. I swear to God, this wood elf is trying to hack through this door, and I'm gonna kill him if he gets in.
How do you... Is it Curas? I've never pronounced that word right.
Curas?
Curas? Is it Curas?
I tried to say it the way she just said it, but my fucking mouth can't work as well.
I think, like, I just habitually said, like, Curas or something, which is not right at all.
Vambrace's...
Yeah. Dad. But the best part of Sirkin is the Rogue 2.0 and the Bard 2.0. That's my favorite part. I have nifty little things, though. Like, I have this celestial scabbard that makes any NPC alliance, like, ally faction with me. I have this super thing. What are you freaking out about? Because did you see they're trying to break down my door?
Do it.
I need my own personal Hodor to hold
it.
I swear to God. I'm they're gonna be real upset when I just leave.
No.
Oh my god, actually. Hold on.
Just summon them and then leave.
Yes. Target Tri-Red server. Summon. Boom. Hi, nerd. Boom! Oh my god, the guard attacked me!
What? What?
Oh, rude. What? So anyway. That was uncalled for.
Uncalled for.
I definitely did not just assassinate one of the guards of Freeport. We'll turn around. But this human being here, since they volunteered to be my guinea pig, has just been timed out, so they can't do shit for 5 minutes. And that's why this ring is awesome. What do you do? This makes me invulnerable, but I have commands for that, so that's stupid. This is my medal of 2 years of service. Because they don't make them higher than 2 years. I'm going to go to Nilvog and be like, I need a custom medal of service, sir. I need a 4-year medal, please. Can we do that?
Oh, man.
Can I just kill this person? I can, right? Because they don't matter.
No.
Oh, it's too late. I'm sorry. They were already dead.
That is how quick the DTs go out.
Mm-hmm. I mean, I'm good at it.
What's worse is now we're... Oh, there it goes. Like, we're watching, so it's, like, super suspenseful. It's like, oh, man, when is it actually going to happen?
Oh, yeah, no.
Yes.
They're never going to get that corpse, ever. I miss Zayd. Zayd used to be a staff member.
You could probably pull it from there.
No one's going to help that person. Oh, you're
they
right.
Just walk into the back of the bank. And do you even play EverQuest?
Not nope. For, like, 4 years, dude. It's been a while. We're gonna go down into sublist and see if anyone's doing anything. So yeah, tell me a story. Ask me a question. Oh, chat! By the way, if you have questions, now is a wonderful time to ask them.
Because I see you go back through Crystal Caverns.
I don't ever want to go to Crystal Caverns again.
Can you make it through again?
No way.
I can't. I don't even know how I made it through the first time.
Really Jones, I've only ever seen once for 200, Alex.
You understand, I felt like a stranger in a foreign land. Why isn't anybody in the crypt? You guys are stupid.
You. Well, you personally. Yes, I'm looking at you, person watching you.
Wait, what?
You need to be in the crypt. You're stupid.
I left the crypt.
Oh.
I went to your stupid butthole zone.
Show
I feel like...
TOV stuff.
Zayd wants NTOV.
What's
nobody
NTOV?
Wants North Temple of Bishan.
No.
I take that back. Nobody. Oh, see, I can't say that because then the casuals would think I was talking shit about them. And that's not what I want to do.
Zeals want MM as if everyone hasn't seen more than enough of that zone.
Casuals think that they're the majority of the player base, and they're not. And that always bugged me. Casuals, you aren't the majority. Now, don't get me wrong. Raiders, the hardcore people, the guilds, the Awakens, and Aftermaths, the Russells, they're definitely not the majority either. But the majority of our player base are people like the two of you. Like Skylius and Uber Bandit, and like a lot of the other streamers. Like Kalal and Famas and Burrito. And people who... legitimately do not care about the things you guys want to burn the world down over. And
well, I mean, they care. Yeah, I mean, Famas and Burrito, they care. They don't.
The day that Burrito
the world,
sends me a tell complaining that he hasn't killed Veneral Sather in 3 months is the day I just hang my hat up and walk away.
He won't do that, but they know their gear.
There hasn't been an event in Crushbone for 3 months.
I'll never... Hey, hold on. I'm gonna wait for stream to catch up to me, and then I'm gonna ask... I need to use a lifeline.
Okay.
How many lifelines did that game show have?
It had three. It had phone a friend, 50-50, and something else.
Poll
the audience?
Yes.
See, I know. I used to watch Who Wants to Be a Millionaire, because I wanted to be a millionaire. I thought that was like a how-to. Is this the bridge that I'm standing on that I'm supposed to drop down?
Mm-hmm, but I need to see below you first, because there's a certain ledge you want to take. So I'll wait 10 minutes.
Well, I mean, there's some ledges below me.
Go for it, Sirkin. Just pick a ledge.
I'm jumping. It's too late. I jumped.
Oh, God.
Sky, he can fly. Calm down.
Okay, that's right.
I jumped on a ledge. I can fly. Fuck this. YOLO, I'm going down.
YOLO.
There's a lot of bridges.
Sirkin, do you think the next CSR lead will have any concept of core game mechanics? Do you think that will help in making decisions?
Sky, huh? I'm going to let you finish, but you're taking my germ.
Oh, that's right. You're good at... Okay, you do the... No, how about you do that last
No, you know what? You had all this motivation.
Oh my God. I just tried to move like it was rust.
Obviously, you can guide. Such a great job.
No, there's two question marks. That's too many.
All right, guys, sit back.
Okay.
Sit back and listen to a profession.
Guys.
All right.
Guys.
Hold on.
I have a dead foreman here. I don't know. Yeah, buddy.
Yes. Do you think the next CSR lead will have any concept of core game mechanics? Do you think that will help in making decisions about infractions and general raid rules?
I think the next CSR lead will have a super gung-ho attitude for about 12 months if they don't get thrown off staff for RMT or being a scumbag. And then, right around that time, they're going to realize that they just don't give a shit and that there's other players with actual problems that need actual help that can't be worked out. Like, it's not possible in this universe to work out without staff assistance, as opposed to problems that players create because they're greedy and unable to work together like civilized human beings. Because essentially what they want me to do is hold their hand and tell them this, that, or the other, and you know what they can do, what they can't do, what's okay, so that they can inch as close to the line as they possibly can while trying to get an edge on the other guild. Shut up, phone. And that just gets super old after 4.5 years. I mean, shit.
So, Sky, the secret there is you have to say Sirkin's name really loud. Otherwise, he just tunes out the entire question and you have to say it again.
Oh. Well, I also noticed that the last question mark you didn't really account for. I was going to put a little bit more emphasis, but I think the way you did that was better. So that was probably your pro tip, actually. You made two question marks, just one.
Well, yeah.
How did that happen?
They should cancel each other out, and it should just become a regular 70 sentence.
70 episodes of experience.
No, for real. I was looking at that stuff because I'm a fucking nerd who keeps track of it on a fucking Excel sheet. And I was like, I miss Uber Bandit. And, I fell again. God damn it. God damn it. This zone is stupid.
Mm-mm.
Can I just cheat and go to guard Kevin?
Mm-mm-mm.
I'm stuck. I got unstuck. I fell. I forgot what the... Oh, no, I didn't forget. I answered his stupid asshole insulting question.
Oh, don't worry. It gets more insulting. Although, Nathan, I'm going to demand a follow-up here, because you have to define cares.
Cares about what?
Yeah.
I mean, do you feel the lead CSR needs to care about the things you care about and prioritize those things in the order that you feel they should be prioritized? Because I don't. I absolutely do not. I feel players with actual problems deserve my help for players who fabricate their own fucking problems. And so, yeah, I don't feel bad when it takes me, you know, a week or two to get to something if it's because I'm helping actual other people. If I'm just doing nothing for 2 weeks, then, yeah, I would feel bad. I'd feel like a shitty, shitty person. But there's literally not a day that goes by except for Sunday, because Sirkin Sunday. But there's not another day that goes by that I'm not doing things for this server. And so... a lot of times people don't see me, but that's because a lot of times I wait for people to be offline before I help them with their petition. And that's just because it's faster. I'm just running in circles and falling again.
That's why, fuck this delay. I can't even.
You're on your own, buddy.
Mm-hmm.
All right, look, I'm just cheating.
You know.
All right. That's the second lifeline. He's down. He only has one lifeline.
Fuck you guys. I didn't use the second lifeline. I didn't. God, no, I didn't. I fell again.
Oh.
But I fell in the snow. That's a good sign. No? All right. I'm turning fly mode on. Because that
good,
needs to
because
be a
that's
thing.
That's going to matter with you being at the bottom. Well.
Oh, maybe that is the real Nathan.
Because he can't understand conversation in context?
No, because of a message someone...
Like it's an elf name?
No, someone just sent me a message in-game from his guild. Mm. And so that's always interesting. I don't know
where
I am.
There's a bridge that you're having us look at?
Sure. Up in the sky there?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I'm up. I'm on that bridge right now. I don't know... I
don't
know. You're going to see some back and forth. It's going to upset you.
Oh my god, no!
Because I had it took me a while. I see guard Kevin.
Okay, now he's go get it.
We did it.
Oh fuck yeah! Now there's a secret stupid wall thing. If I remember,
not really.
Yeah, it's secret.
No.
Yeah.
Sorry, there's a built-in delay to Twitch because of the way that internet works.
No, there's a built-in delay to Twitch because next-gen consoles.
Just keep going down that hallway you're going down. Just
No. I'm close. No, I got this. I'm a GM. Mm. I think I know the zones better than any player possibly ever could. Every zone.
No.
It's like Neo. Just I zone in and all the information is automatically loaded into my brain.
Bad. You're so close.
That's why I'm always right all the time. Because...
Stop moving! You need... Wait, hold on. Are you done moving?
No.
I can hear your fucking keyboard.
Yeah, no, I'm not done moving. What are you talking about? I'm an adventure... Oh, I found Guard Kevin. He's walking through the wall.
Oh, God, Guard Stacy!
Guard Stacy? I found a merchant! I found a bunch of merchants! And a miner!
Oh, Lord. He just discovered a cool day in town.
Super exciting. I can make new friends here. Mm-mm. That way I won't have to cry at night because Nathan doesn't like me.
You're following the worst
Bowie!
NPC
Bowie!
Ever in EverQuest.
Maybe.
No, there's Guard Joss on.
Bowie, this is not a replay. I'm doing things in Crystal Caverns. I'm looking for Guard Stacy at the moment. It seems like every NPC just like left the area though. So I don't know. I don't know what I did wrong. I was trying to follow directions. I'm really good at listening to directions.
I told you, Guard Stacy, because that's
Guard Stacy left. All right, that bitch went home. Oh no, Slacy, she's fighting a thing. She killed a thing.
So you're supposed to.
No, I got this. I told you.
That one,
I know.
Down to the right, down over that bridge.
I'm so far past that.
To the right. Take a hard right after that.
I hope I end up going that way.
Yep.
You're going to be
go
real upset.
There. Go through there. Yeah. Go. Just ignore them fighting things.
I can't. You know.
How do I get there?
Okay.
Okay.
I found.
Keep going.
I found the wall that I made sweet love to last time.
Yeah, you just don't worry about any kind of hidden doors or anything. It's left. Yeah. Keep going down that hallway. It's probably already out of there right now.
I found a Ixar Necro.
Go over the bridge.
Oh, I did. Don't worry. I know that I made sweet love to that wall. Me and that wall are on a first name basis.
Who did it better, Uthgard or
Melinda? Sky, fucking amateur.
No,
you're
there was no
the
second.
Question.
There was no. Oh,
I
you
know.
Fucking
you're
amateur.
The question.
What?
Okay.
What? You guys are just letting me wander through like these pink ass caverns.
Sir,
what's up?
What do y'all do about gear and plot that was taken from an account when information was never shared? Dovar says he was gone for a while and came back to everything gone.
Petition form.
No, you were going to where the queen was. Turn around.
Right, I turned around. I'm back at the,
Go to the bridge that you were just at where there were spiders. Okay, you're back at the group. No, turn around. I want to see if the queen's up.
Okay. Is the queen at the end of that tunnel that the Ixar was looking down?
Yeah, yep.
All right, I'll go back in there.
Hey, Kate.
Hi, Kate. Going over bridge. She's not up.
No, did you go all the way down?
I went all the way down. I always go all the
over,
way down.
Over the bridge.
Over the bridge, through the woods, past grandma's house, yes, to the spider web. I know.
Oh.
I did all of the things.
Oh yeah, you sure did. Seeing that now.
Yeah, I got juice. I got sent on a wild goose chase.
Mm.
Oh,
well, you
man.
Got the geos to the right, the right of that, and then to the left you've got the stalags.
The geos are to the right?
Yeah.
Like when I come out of the tunnel?
Yeah, if you go down where that necro's just chilling, to the right of him, yeah, if you're facing the way he's facing, which would be down the tunnel, to
uh-huh.
the right the geos, to the left would be the stalags.
To the right of the way he's... Oh, yeah, in the dirty cave. I remember in here. It was dirt.
Yeah, those guys. Mm-hmm.
What
oh, I did it.
Call, what is your worst zone in the game?
besides Wes Karana?
Karana.
Karana. Wes Karana. It's no, it's Wes Karana is the stupidest zone in the game. Like I honestly feel like, okay, so you guys may or may not know this, but you should know the first zone was South Quainos, right? So then I imagine after that it was North Quainos, and then and then after that it was Quainos Hills, and then and then after that it was like, let's do West Karana. And so
I don't know though, because the Karanas are like distinctly large.
Thank you, Uber.
Hold on, I'm getting to that. So they throw down this big ass West Karana and they're super excited, and they all come back from lunch like fucking ready to do some shit. And they throw down, they're like, you know what we should have like right out of the gate when you leave Quainos Hills is farms, because you want the farms and the food to be close to the city. So let's put farms in West Karana right next to the Quainos Hills entrance. And, you know, it's got to be close to water because plants need water. And it just all made sense. I went to fucking Sebelis again. God damn it. That's not what I meant to type.
I'm trying to think.
Hold on. This is good.
Karanas are simple enough, but I might say that maybe, like, the common lands came before then.
No. No, listen. Listen. They put down the farms, right? And then they're like, well, what else do we need in West Karana? And someone was like, what preys on farmers? And this other guy was like, bandits! So they start scattering bandits, you know, along the water and some treed areas maybe for shelter. But water's the source of life, so they're there. And they're we need something else.
Cat Fox points out an important thing. I forgot Quainos Catacombs.
Fuck Quainos Catacombs. It's not part of my story. And so... They're like, this other guy's like, oh, dude, you're tired. You know, let me do some shit. And so he, who had nothing to do with the people who did the farms and bandits, was like, you know, I'm going to put some ogres next to these stones in West Karana, because why not? And then it was 5 o'clock and everybody just left. And West Karana ended like that. And so everything fucking east of there is just open, useless fucking space. Because that's what happened that day at 5 o'clock. That's my theory on West Karana. And now if you want to talk like most horriblest dungeons, Guk. Guk is stupid.
Guk is pretty bad.
Like, I can't deal with Guk.
Fuck,
Guk.
Why do you put such a tiny, like, closed-in indoors area right next to the troll start? We talk about that first.
Ooh.
So that the dark races can have a dungeon?
Mean, you have... Isn't CT, like, the same level?
As Guk?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. No, it's like 30, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
But you can do, like, upper and then lower Guk for almost ever.
I'm so sick of this zone. Can we not see Casey? I feel like there's a lot of Casey.
It's so easy for me to just, like, hide in a corner and not pay attention.
My druid would be 60 if it wasn't for Casey.
Do you have a different zone that you would like me to go to? Because I'm just roaming the lands.
North TOV.
That's a shitty zone.
I'm kidding.
Sweet.
I don't know.
All day.
It's too Touch late. Yeah, it's too late. I've already typed Temple Vishon. We're going there.
I've probably spent like 50% of my EverQuest time in Crushbone.
Aw.
My dad got his Father's Day card. Okay.
You're late.
No, I sent it on Friday, goddammit. I know.
They're on
site. Well, he lives 20 minutes away. And so...
You could have delivered it yourself.
But no. No.
I hate this zone.
Oh my god. See, okay, I'm okay with this.
I think I may dislike Everfrost.
Oh, Everfrost is awesome.
Go to the Timorous Deep and go to the Everfrost. Fire Pots.
The thing about Everfrost is it has, like, super griffins in those undead bars that wander around. Like, that place is just a constant danger zone. It's like, hi, I'm a level, like, 14, 15 undead bard. I heard you were trying to level.
Nope. Bards are the worst. Yeah. I mean...
Neck sucks pretty bad.
Yeah, go to the fire pots and in Timorous.
I have to run there because I don't actually know, like...
The location.
Yeah. What is it? Southwest? It's the southwest corner. I know that. What is this? North? So that makes southwest this way. That's west. Oh, I'm already at the chessboard? Let's do it.
Dovar wants to know if P99 will ever go to Luckland.
No.
Fuck no.
No, but I mean...
Just tell him where it is gonna go.
It's... Well, we don't know for sure, but I will tell you that I know there's devs who do want to do custom content. I can't... Oh, I'm on your favorite island in the whole fucking world. I wish I could talk about things, but the problem is I don't really know things. I only know what I would like to see. And I know I would like to see a lot. And I know that if the devs can... Oh, wow, that was easy. I know if the devs can get all the things they want to get, that's going to be a very Merry Christmas one Christmas here on P99. Because we definitely... There are definitely devs who want to keep doing things after Velius. They just don't want to do Luckland.
Shazon, I can answer that for you.
Answer that. Simon
has no idea, but I'm pretty sure if the devs knew about things falling through, they've either tried to fix it or can't fix it.
Wait, what did he say?
The question is, I know you don't do the dev work, but do they plan on fixing pathing / mobs falling through the world and walls at some point?
Bug report.
Yeah.
I mean, yes. If something's broken, it needs to be fixed. 100%, yes. There's a chance that it hasn't been bug reported. There's a chance it has been bug reported and they think it's fixed and it's not. So then you need to go in and be like, hey, you think you fixed this, but it's not fixed.
Also, maybe search before you post the new bug thread. Maybe someone else was reported. Compile information.
You made it.
Collaborate.
Do people know this is why they can't bind here?
I'm sure they probably just think we're assholes.
Because this place is OP.
My play character is bound here. He should still be bound here. I don't think I ever rebound. But I remember, like, the moment Kunark launched and we all got on the goddamn boats. Actually, I was making a bunch of money selling Levitate DMF because for some reason the boats were killing people that weren't levitated. And then Uthgard came and, like, mass-leved everybody and put me out of business. So that was sad. But yeah, then I ran here and bound because everybody was acting like we only had 20 minutes to do it instead of like weeks and weeks.
Planes of Power is one of the ones that a lot of people have talked about, and ideas have been thrown around in here before talking about, like, you know, putting like the key to go into the planes in like a clever fire pot or shit like that.
I mean, if it was me, if it was just my server and there was, you know, I could do whatever I wanted and it didn't require help from devs or staff or anything, and I was just the big head honcho god of the world, I would definitely try to do something like that. I would take one of the POP zones and I would just link them somewhere in the world and not tell anybody. Like, I would take the Plane of Nightmare and make something a zone line in Fear that brings you there, and it would be open for like 2 weeks, and then I'd close it and put a different plane somewhere else. And I would just rotate what was available with
you. Just walk into the zone line.
Mm-hmm. Well, I mean, it'd probably be something you have to click on, maybe, if
no,
that's
no,
a possibility.
Sorry, on the stream.
On the stream,
you just turned
just...
around and walked into the zone.
Oh, yeah, I'm leaving.
Right into the zone.
I'm leaving Akanon.
Mm-hmm.
Why didn't you just go straight in the steam pond?
I wanted to use the fire pot.
Oh, I didn't see you use the fire pot.
Yeah.
Why are we in steam pond?
Yeah, why didn't you take the one to CT?
Oh, wait, go check kobolds. Do you know where kobolds are?
The steam font kobolds?
Yeah, the steam font kobolds.
I literally just ran past them.
Look.
What?
Understand that you're now headed over there and you're running past the steam font kobolds. The steam font kobolds were great because I took, when I made a bard, I took my bard to go swarm those at level 3.
Uh-huh.
And let me tell you, if you've never swarmed without cellos at level 3, it's a lot of clench.
I'm gonna do a thing real quick. It's gonna be good. I can't say it. Well,
frog bomb.
Yes. But
frogs are so boring.
I know, but I don't get in trouble for those. Although, actually, I might. Let's do fine spell mass.
Guilds would give out DKP for scouting if you did the hidden plane thing. Agreed.
Oh, fuck yeah, they would. It would be awesome, because then if a guild actually found it, like, it would be super huge to keep that on lockdown and not tell anybody so you could farm the shit out of it. And just be, like, what if a casual guild found it? What if fucking Anonymous was to find, like, the plane of whatever before anybody else and was able to farm that?
I know,
and you would have guilds like Awakened and Russell and Aftermath freaking out because there's loots happening that they can't get on, and
yeah,
I think it would be dope.
They would be doing stuff.
Or put like take an NPC in the world that doesn't do anything and give it text to be like, hail, and they'd be like, hail, adventurer, I'm studying this whole new plane. There's all kinds of things there. Would you like to go there and help? And you'd be like, yes, send me to the plane of bloody blah. And then you get whisked away to bloody blah land. Like, just something. Something that's just hidden in plain sight. And people would run past it all the time and have no idea that that's a thing. And I think it would be pretty cool. And then after 2 weeks, it would close. Whoosh, portal done. Think like Oblivion Gates. It would be excellent. You'd have different planes opening and closing at different times in different parts of the world. And I just think it would be a really, really great, amazing, but super non-classic idea.
Like, would you announce that something had been opened at all?
Yes.
So you'd be like, hey, there's,
right, because I would want people
to plane of blah, blah, blah.
Yes, I would want people to run around clicking on things and trying to find it and mm-hmm. giving me things to giggle about. I would need that in my life.
And I mean, maybe, what if, and you know, like, each successive day has, well, the thing is, you'd run out of planes pretty quickly.
No, I wouldn't.
Will Bard Swarm Kiting ever be nerfed on the server?
Will Bard Swarm Kiting ever be nerfed? I think Bard should just be removed from this whole server.
I mean, the real answer is Shit's Classic Gish.
I just got messages from somebody. Hold on, I gotta do a thing now. What is it? 6575 maybe.
I saw the messages that you just got. I love him.
6575.
Was ish mean? Sort of. It's classic ish.
Are you going there?
Oh yeah.
What the fuck?
Oh yep.
What the fuck is that? Hold on. What is that weird underarm tentacle rock thing?
Weird underarm tentacle rock?
It's a question.
Are you talking about the butt grabber?
Is that what that is?
Right, it looks like it's made for grabbing butts.
They give it to you when you have surgery.
Oh, another unicorn. That ruins everything.
Yeah, I thought that was a lot better.
Aw, what is it, 13? No, 12? Yes, but now he's too big. And, oh no, he was always a girl. I think I broke him.
Classic-ish
zero.
Theoretically. Bards are swarm kiting under the same methods that were possible in Classic, just computers couldn't handle it to the same level they're doing it now.
And bards are stupid.
It was technically possible. Like, it's the same system, just different hardware.
Oh,
same
oh,
with,
wow.
like, the AoE and Seb. Like, it was possible then, just not to the degree it's done now. You just crash everyone and they get reset.
I mean, I just made a fucking circle. That sucks. If I had my magic wand, I would 100% make it so there was some kind of limit on how many NPCs could be aggroed on a player at a certain time.
That would fix a lot of things. Except, I mean, you're nerfing power leveling, which is, you know, sort of like an EverQuest thing.
I mean, shit's classic, though. What's up, Kalal? I was watching your stream earlier today.
He streamed today?
Yeah, he did. Hold on. Twitch.tv. I said your stream earlier, but I didn't actually type it out because I was feeling lazy, but Uber Bandit made me spell it twice. So I feel that kind of counts. But there you go. You guys should go there and you should plug him. Or no, don't plug him. But I'll plug him. And you should follow, is what I'm trying to say. He's a good streamer. He went away for a while. You might have known him from back before. But he's back now. He streams. I don't know what time he streams. I don't pay enough attention. I want to say, like, not super late nights, but maybe early evening, late afternoons. But it doesn't matter. Hit his follow button, and you'll definitely not miss things. And Kate, too. And Burrito doesn't need help, Calvin. Burrito's doing just fine. And I'm pretty sure he's an asshole from everything I've heard.
Oh, gosh.
No.
Well, it's late night at the Roxbury again. Can you do me a favor real quick? Sorry. Can you walk up to Fitta? I gotta see Fitta. Gnome Fitta.
Let me do a fly mode oon.
You don't need to. Fitta's right in front of your face.
Yeah, but now I can get, like, right in Fitta's grill.
Oh, whoa. Okay.
Sorkin.
Yeah, buddy.
Guaca Koala wants to know, did the cancellation of EQ Next affect P99's future at all?
No. Not even a no. Not for a second, no.
Oh my god, that hair.
There is nobody in the world playing EQ Next who would enjoy P99.
Mm-mm.
Like, there's just not. And to be super honest, I don't think anybody... Right, so you know how, like, MMOs and a lot of games promise the world, and then as it gets closer and closer to release, less and less of what is promised is going to end up being in the product? Mm-hmm. And MMOs especially, they've been promising the world, and then they come out and they've all failed to deliver. And granted, some MMOs get better after launch, they put in work, but at launch, they're real bad. And, oh, shit.
No. You know what MMO I have my ear to the ground for?
What?
Huh.
The repopulation.
I don't even know what that is.
Yeah, you don't. So, they have a little of a troubled history so far because they were working off of something called the Hero Engine, and the Hero Engine basically went bankrupt and did some questionable stuff, so they basically lost their game. So... now they're redeveloping it on, I think it's Unreal 3 or 4. And it's sort of like if, like, EverQuest and the old Star Wars MMO that was actually good. Galaxies, right? I think?
The Old Republic no one really liked.
No, the older Star Wars MMO. I think it's Galaxies.
Star Wars Galaxies was popular. Yeah, I didn't play it, but... people say
it's
real,
like,
good
EverQuest
things.
It's like if EverQuest and Galaxies had a baby and then did some other stuff.
Sounds hot.
Yeah.
I'd like to watch EverQuest make a baby.
Yeah, Star Wars Galaxies, they has it. Repopulation. Like, it's not out for playing yet again, and it was even in, like, pretty early alpha when it was a thing.
Sure.
But that is an MMO that I have hopes for. Namely because the team lost their entire game and then decided not to give up. After, like, being 3 months in limbo, not having a game.
How did they lose it?
So, they were using an engine called the Hero Engine. Uh-huh. And basically, they violated the terms of their agreement because Hero Engine weren't actually, like, doing anything. They, like, terminated, so it got weird.
Okay.
It was a weird legal process, and the short of it ended up that they had the IP, but not the engine.
Okay,
they didn't
so
have right to the engine anymore.
Just dumb.
Yeah.
Okay.
Dumb happened.
Yeah.
Dumb happened, and suddenly they had an IP but no game engine.
Huh.
Also dumb.
Hey, you want to hear something that's really dumb?
Apparently, yeah. This is time to share the dumb stories.
Okay, they're remastering Skyrim.
Dumb.
That's pushing the delay of Elder Scrolls 6. Yeah.
Dumb.
Wait, what?
All
yeah.
dumb.
Yeah. Wait. Remastering Skyrim because... Wait.
Because we don't have a modding community that's already doing that.
Yep.
Wait.
And has been doing that for like 5 years. And
I knew this would be... Yeah, see, Uber's not going to recover. I think he might be done for... I should have saved that for the end.
You just killed my friend.
I'm sorry.
I heard... No, here's the thing. I heard it. Like, I heard that... Like, but I thought they were kidding. Or like,
no,
it was
no.
a mis... Like, I didn't think that could happen in the reality I lived in.
Okay, I'm really going to destroy Christmas, but they even talked about it at E3 like it was something worth talking about.
Oh, they made a big deal out of it.
E3 yeah. is a convention of things not worth talking about.
I mean,
can count on one hand the number of successful games, like, this year, like, good games that came out this year that were at E3.
I can...
That's kind
of You know, that's probably true, yeah. I can. I was going to say, I can only think of maybe one to three things
yeah.
about E3 that I was like, that's
actually
awesome.
Doesn't matter.
No. Stop. Okay, he ruined Christmas for me. So
yeah, he switched that up.
That wasn't cool at all. I thought I was destroying your world, but apparently you had to just go make all this sense.
I mean, that's why I just don't watch it, because it's like, I'm not actually listening. It's like, it's going to be sequels.
Well, okay, so I guess it's appropriate for them to announce the remastering of Skyrim. Yeah. For console gamers, buy a fucking computer.
Seriously, if you're playing... I'm not going to shit on console gamers. I'm not going to do that. But I will shit on you if you're playing Elder Scrolls on a console. Because what you can do with mods, even just a couple... is amazing, and well, it's not like shit to completely change the game. It's just little things that make the game a little bit better and a little bit more realistic, and things that the actual Bethesda devs should have done.
Literal
yeah,
bug
no, they're
things.
Saying
yes.
Yeah, oh well, that's Bethesda. It's Bugthesda. Like
uh-huh.
after a certain yeah. amount of time, but
oh,
but
that,
yeah.
Which
so,
by the way, you're playing on console without console commands.
Right.
Meaning,
and
if that NPC gets stuck somewhere, your save is dead.
Pretty much. And also, I've played on console. I played Morrowind, and I played Oblivion on console. I played Skyrim on console, and then
yep.
I went to play Skyrim on my PC, and was like, oh, okay, this makes a lot more sense. But now that they're holding up Elder Scrolls 6 for the remastering... And, yeah, somebody just mentioned it, and I couldn't be in more agreement. Like, they fucked up ESO.
Yeah, they did.
So...
That game was so different. Like, if you look at the old... If you go find YouTubers that had access to, like, the early alpha testing shit of that, and you listen to what the shit they were... They weren't allowed to show footage, but they were talking about it. And you listen to the shit they were talking about. Fast forward 6 months, do it again. Fast forward 6 months, fast forward to launch... It's a completely different game, and the original idea was so much more ES, like Elder Scrolls based than MMO based, and at
yeah.
some point in the alpha and beta, they just shifted more towards MMO, and they started trying to please both crowds, the Elder Scroll people and the MMO people, and they just made a giant, giant mess of everything.
Like, I had a buddy that was in on like the process like the whole way through. And it started off, he was like, it's all right, it's going somewhere. And just every month I'd check in. And eventually it was, I don't want to talk about it.
Ooh,
oh, wait,
easy, easy. Yeah, I was going to jump
Bethesda.
All over
no,
that.
I knew that. No, that, no. I know that Bethesda did not make ESO. No.
No, we can thank ZeniMax for that.
Yeah, that's ZeniMax. And I'm pretty sure that they fired their whole dev team like 3 or 4 months in on that shit. So... yeah, that's not on Bethesda.
But you know it is on Bethesda? All the buggy bullshit bugs in every game they've ever made, ever.
Yeah.
I know, but you can't come in here and defend Bethesda when we start talking shit about bugs.
No.
Like, they make great games, but I could not play... I'm the same as you. I played Morrowind and Oblivion and Skyrim all on the console first. And then for the second playthrough, when I put this machine together, I was like, oh, I'm going to play some Skyrim.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
And Oh man, I didn't even need a lot of mods. I just wanted the one to put the road on the map, and like one or two other stupid little things for like quality of life things like that. And that was it. And then bugs were fixed already, because patches and shit, and life went on. And if something was messed up, I could go in the console and reset it. So.
Yeah, no, I was super excited. Yeah. I was super excited for ESO. I mean, I played the beta.
Oh, yeah.
Was super excited. And then when it came out, on, of course, for PC, I played it for a while, then saw that they had their bot problem become worse and exaggerated. The only thing that I really enjoyed about that was actually the armor crafting. That was actually a lot of fun. But other than that, yeah, that's when I was like, I'm done with this. Like, there was a point where I couldn't get any further in the game just because of a stupid quest, because I couldn't click on a fucking goblet, and it had to do with moon sugar, and yeah, so I couldn't go to a whole nother area. So I was stuck for like 2 or 3 weeks. And then they had a bot problem, but the bot problem became like a mini game within a game. Then you could like go and work on trying to like push them so that they couldn't sit there for the repops and all of that, and you'd try to like get them into corners, and then you'd watch them run down the stairs, and there'd be, you know, a good like 50 of them. So it was fun watching them. Then yeah, no more. But Pantheon, I am looking forward to Pantheon.
I have so much hope and faith, and just praying that Seaman, go fuck yourself. I have so much hope and faith in that game, that it will be good. But I'm so scared to have hope and faith in any game,
Yep.
And I want to, because I know that those people know how to make a good game, and I know that those people want to make a good game. I'm just terrified on how it will actually play out in reality.
Right. I hear there's
like the perception of what makes a good game is really skewed right now, because it involves mostly precedent.
Well, you have to not so try to make a game for everybody. You have to figure out who you're gonna fucking target and focus on that demographic. And stop trying to make the next World of Warcraft. Stop trying to make a game that will make everyone happy to get everybody to play it. Stop fucking doing dumb shit.
You know how unexciting it is to say that, though, to a board of investors?
I don't care.
Elder Scrolls is making a strategy card game like Hearthstone. and yeah, just FYI, everybody, I know.
Just rename Hearthstone Wheel of Fortune.
Wow.
I think I just boosted your viewers by at least two.
Yeah, I'll slam Hearthstone all day.
Wow.
But first, now for something completely different. Okay. Dovar wants to know, Sirkin.
He just followed me.
Is the player base of P99 growing, or is the server dying?
It's going to go down because of summer. It's my fourth summer on staff here. And every summer, we lose some numbers, and then when the temperature gets cold and everyone comes back inside, our numbers go up. Yeah. I mean, there's always new people. I can't show you character names, but I get a notice every time a new character is created on the server. Mm-hmm. And it's basically so that if a staff member's online and someone makes a stupid name, we can deal with it instantly. And so I can see how often new characters are created. And then also, as you both know, I spent a decent amount of time either lurking in chats or chatting in chats on this here Twitch. And I see people talk to streamers and be like, oh, what is this? I didn't know this was a thing. How can I play this? And so you guys are all constantly bringing new players to the community. Yes, we definitely lose players for tons and tons of reasons. Most recently, I know we've lost players because they're just unhappy. That's
video games.
Well, that's one of the good things about there being so many different versions of EverQuest out there. If you want, you know, a competitive classic environment, you have P99. If you want instance rating and no competition rating and you just want free shit, then you can go to Live, because they have all of those things.
And TLP.
Yeah, well, I wouldn't even consider the other live servers. When I say go to live, I'm always talking those TLP servers.
Okay, so you encapsulate both of those.
Yeah, I should have been more specific, but yeah, I don't even, I don't consider the other live servers to even exist anymore. But the TLP servers, I think, are good. I think it's, I think it was awesome of Daybreak to make a no two boxing server. I mean, I know that's a thing we do, and I understand from a business point of view why you would not care, as long as they're, you know, making different accounts and paying for them. But it's not good for the community in a game like EverQuest. Like, you need, EverQuest is built around people needing each other. And if you take that need out, you're taking, like, a core dynamic out of the gameplay. Oh my god, I guess I can go do a petition real quick.
Dropcore wants to know, that is Monk's name, L-O-H-H, surname Fat, with P-H, be okay.
Legal counsel, why is that bad?
I mean, it mildly resembles, like, a compound name thing that is technically against the copy-pasted naming policy.
Man, I don't know. Make, I don't even know.
I believe the short version and the answer, I usually tell people, you know, not actually being the people that validate this, but just, like, what I see is, as long as your name isn't stupid, and as long as nobody reports it, and as long as none of the staff think it's stupid, you're fine. The rules are not incredibly hard and fast unless you're just being obviously, openly.
Yeah, dark. Don't be dense. I mean,
Can that dwarf do a dive roll for me, please? Kegulus, please?
Do a...
Fucking get that. Get that barbarian out of there. I want to see the dwarf dive roll, please.
Dive roll.
Yes.
Do you guys investigate those whom you give IP exemptions to make sure they're not one person in two boxing? From Ongfei.
Did you hear that, Sirkin?
No, I'm watching this dwarf do barrel rolls.
You didn't say his name loud enough, or did you not even say it at all?
I didn't say it.
I don't think he said it at all. How are you supposed to get my attention?
Sirkin!
Yes.
Okay, go Uber.
I mean, are you ready to say yes?
Sure.
All right, do you investigate people who you give IP exemptions to make sure they're not two boxing?
Every single time.
There you go. I mean, two boxing is sort of the biggest, well, the second biggest no brainer?
No. I'd say, like, third party programs is probably second to RMT.
Yeah.
I mean, if you want to be technical, probably DDoSing the server. Is
that's like outside the game though, that doesn't count.
All right, well, it affects the inside.
That's like the zeroth one.
I suppose that might be a thing.
Fuck, I remember playing during like one of the bad ones.
All right, nerds, if you have questions, now is the speed round. Throw your questions out there.
All right, well.
While they're waiting, I will say. Going way back to a thing, we didn't care about EQ Next, and we don't care about any other game, because history has shown us for essentially the last 12 years that every fucking MMO that comes out is going to suck. And so we're not worried about it. And non-MMOs, people are going to beat the game and come back to our P99. It's straight up addicting.
I mean, not to mention that, like, I think you've quoted Nilbog, or at least referenced Nilbog, and, like, he would be working on this even if nobody was playing.
Yes.
Like, he just wanted to see EverQuest.
When he started working, nobody was playing.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, fuck.
All right, Sirkin.
Yeah.
When is the next XP event?
I have no idea. But right. I think we made a post about it that we were going to... I don't... All right, look. Go to the front page of the forums, www.project1999.com. Go there. Check the news and announcements on the homepage and see if there's a mention about XP bonuses, because I know there's a plan. I just don't know if we said the plan, and I don't want to say it if we didn't say it.
Plan confirmed.
Plan confirmed.
Why don't you ever play music on stream?
Because I upload these to YouTube, and YouTube's all shitty about flagging things for copyright.
What are you talking about? They work
actually,
great.
Twitches too. Like Twitch will mute sections of your stream that have copyright music.
Oh yeah, yeah, yeah. But Twitch didn't do that when I first started, so that right. didn't happen to me.
Right.
But what did happen to me was I'd upload it to YouTube, and then I'd get shit on by YouTube, and then I was just no more music.
They take a hit at Canada and Germany. A lot of videos get blocked in those countries. Mm.
I've had videos blocked in Australia.
Oh, that too.
Yeah.
Yeah. Silver wants to know
if pets steal 50% of XP.
I don't know.
They don't in groups, and they don't when you're
leveling. I feel like they don't
if you deal
enough damage.
I don't remember if you deal more than 51% damage. Basically, if you deal the majority of the damage, the pet will not steal XP from you.
Yeah.
They never steal XP in a group.
All right.
At least how it worked back when I played a mage.
Or just get a bunch of those little green malachites and then just pet get lost if you're soloing.
That's the other thing is you can
or reclaim energy
the pet right before you killing blow the thing.
And then you get all of it.
Yeah, reclaim the energy and then nuke it down, you get all the XP. Or just duo with another mage and you're both getting equal XP as if you're just being lazy mages.
I have to deal with this.
Go ahead. Yeah, because it's actually that's gonna go to both of you because I'm gonna make sure Uber's a part of it too. So Kalal's actually talking to you, Sirkin, and Uber Bandit. This is a threat to both of you. You guys are both gonna be screwed on the next Quiplash.
Here's
the
question,
you fucking amateur, get out. Dropcord wants to know when the next major pot should schedule.
I have no idea. Anyway, I have no idea when patches are because that's like dev stuff and Rogan stuff. That's definitely not Sirkin stuff. I mean, they'd have to give me at least 2 more Bloomin' Onions a week if they wanted me to start dealing with things like that. Here's the thing, Kalal. I think you might be right. My brain, I feel like there's so much pressure on me to do good at Quiplash that my brain fucking panics. And so then I'm trying to think outside the box because my first reaction is usually butts. And then... I can't do that anymore, and if there's no, like, thing that was just, like, a flavor of the, like, minute word, like, dick, or moist, or cookies, or something like that, then it gets more difficult. And then the third round, they give you, like, 4 seconds to pick a fucking answer. And so I don't know. I don't know. I need to, like, just get real drunk and try not to give any shits at all.
Candora's boobs are on your stream, and I kind of love it, because that's Candy. I keep seeing hi, Candy, and because Candy was in my guild when I first started.
Stream, yeah. No, there are definitely boobs in my stream right now.
As far as Quiplash, I will say this. Sky.
Falal's going to... What?
Bat phone me for the next Quiplash.
Oh, I will.
Put Falal in this place.
Oh, I'd really love to see a lot of the people from P99 play that. Oh. I know they used to, but...
I did so bad last time. I think the...
You did terrible.
It was bad. I got lucky on one because nobody answered against me.
I first ever round of Quiplash.
Yeah, he did.
Easy DC wants to know what you think of the Pantheon MMO.
Again, I have a lot of faith in it. I'm hoping... I have a lot of hope, I guess. I don't know if faith is the right word, but hope. I have a lot of hope.
Hoping against hope.
Yeah, I feel like if Pantheon sucks, I'm just giving up. Or, like, if Pantheon doesn't come out, or, like, that's it. That is my last hope, is Pantheon. And, I mean, I definitely support it. I definitely want it to come out and be good. I'm definitely going to try it. I'm definitely going to do whatever I can do about it. Yeah. So that's the thing.
All right, that's the speed round.
That's the speed round? Oh my lord.
Yeah, talk about killing dragons. I'm pulling the plug there.
They're gonna kill dragons?
You're getting to kill dragon killing. Yeah. Lewis says probably gonna kill the shit out of some dragons.
Hmm.
If I didn't have integrity, you'd be banned from this channel.
Damn.
That's Kegulus. Is
yeah.
that how we say that?
I don't know. Cause it's weird. Cause the U comes after the L.
It's okay. He was doing dive rolls.
Yes. He's been on the server for a long time. Me and him have had good talks, and we've had very bad talks. And there's probably been times he's wanted to murder me. And there's definitely been times that he wasn't my favorite person on the server.
As your legal counsel, I advise you death touch him before he kills the dragon.
I cannot DT anybody in this zone, or the amount of tears and shits that will go off. Literally, Rogan will like just appear in this room and be like, "What are you doing?" And I won't even have a good bullshit answer to give. Like, I cannot be that GM that starts DTing players in TOV.
No, not TOV. Go do it to Kalal. He just said you could. He's in the Warrens.
That's not.
No. Nope. Nope. That's a trap.
That is a trap. Well done, Kalal.
Oh, that's no good. Well, everybody, since you seem not to have any more questions, I would say thank you very much for hanging out and hanging out with us. We had fun hanging out with you. Skylius, I'm going to give you a wonderful opportunity to say goodbye to these people as I make up words to fill time while I type out your Twitch address.
Goodbye these people.
That's very good.
Yeah, I know that sounds so terrible. I'm so glad that I saw Candora. But yes, goodbye everybody.
Uh-huh. And Uber Bandit.
Yo.
Arguably the very best, most consistent, frequent streamer on all of Twitch.
I am actually playing the stream Masterwork Reborn because playing that game solo is no fun. There will be Dwarf Fortress in the future.
You've been playing Ark.
I've been playing a lot of Ark. I can't stream Ark, though. I don't think my computer would be very happy with me.
You probably shouldn't I don't know. On some servers, you should definitely not stream Ark.
Nah, we're on a PvE server, so.
So it's not as bad. I know I would never stream Rust.
PvE server with, like, 5 people.
Like, I won't even upload a Rust video while that round is still active. Like, I won't do it. Well, yeah, Uber Bandit, I'm very happy you were here this evening. And Skylius, I'm very happy you could join us this evening as well. And I hope you guys had fun. And I'm going to put you on hold in a second. Maybe, if I can find the buttons. There we go. They're on hold. Hey, guys. It's just us. I'm real glad you all hung out, and I'm real hoping? Yeah, fuck it. I'm real hoping that you guys had a good time. I had a good time. I'm looking for things. I'm a little bit rusty. I do apologize. But I'm going to play my exit video, and then I'm going to send you over to another fantastic streamer who streams P99. And... yeah, I hope you guys have a wonderful Monday night. Oh my god, I forgot things. If you missed things and you want to catch up on them, youtube.com/circump99. And I don't have to tell you where you are now, but twitch.tv/circump99, just in case you're lost. That's where you are now. I'll talk to you fine. Oh my god! And www.project1999.com for all the classic EverQuest things. See, I told you, I'm super rusty. But I will talk to you swell people later. Goodbye. Nope, that's the wrong one, guys. That's the wrong one. See ya.